فرحان قف بينو للهلولة حد سلحطو محيلة ضربو شوفارة الليلة احنا جايين من كل مكان لصورة زينة البلدان زورو ونرجع فرحان
بشوت مغاي برابو ديف دي بيوشينو فاشيم. Today I would like to see this Dvar Torah in the memory of our brother, friend, father, Menachem Mendel ben Yossef Rosental, Alav Shalom, that everybody loves him, everybody called him Miguel, Mickey, Miguel Rosental, Alav Shalom. Well, unfortunately, he passed away after a long period of being not well, and may Hashem give him up there his place that he deserved with the big tzaddikim, all what he did as a reward for all what he did in this world when he was alive. Today is the week of Matan Torah, the week that Hashem give the Torah to the Bnei Israel. It's a week, it's a special week after that the Jews left Egypt, and after that the Jews were 400 slaves in Egypt. Now Hashem give them the freedom. It says Mitzrayim, the exit of Egypt. And as all of you know, that all the reason why Hashem give this freedom to the Jews, it's to receive the Torah. Now, after all the miracles that Hashem he did to the Jews in Egypt, and during the crossing of the sea, now the time come to give them the Torah. My friend, those who will ask this silly question, and a lot of times people ask this question, it's like today somebody asked me, Rabbi David, do you love God? Or people will come and ask, Rabbi, do you really, you believe? And all those miracles that happened in Egypt, a lot of times, people ask questions. And be honest, you must have a lot of faith to believe on all this. And the emuna, faith, it's not, you don't get it just like that. Sometimes I feel so surprised from people that they ask me, is it real? Is it true? Is it this? Is it this? And the Torah, if you read the Torah, it said, when the Jews wanted to fight the Egyptians, Hashem, he said, no, there is no fight. Hashem ilachem lachem ve'atem taharishon. You just be quiet. Hashem will do the fight. You don't do the fight. Even that you have weapons, you don't do the fight. Hashem, Yahem Lachem, Vatim Taharishun. Hashem, he will do the fight for you. And that's what happened. Hashem, he did the fight for the Jews. The Jews, they crossed the sea, and then the Bnei Israel started to sing. They sing, they were so happy as Hashem Moshe Bnei Israel, and then out of the sea, the Egyptians, they brought with them a lot of gold, a lot of wealth. And when everything, when the Egyptians did drown in the sea, all that gold, all that money, silver, all what the Egyptians did brought with them, it come up to the surface of the sea, and the Jews were taken. Then Moshe told him, stop, you have to go. Hashem did not do all these miracles just for fun, just basta, enough, you have enough. And then they went in the desert during 3 days. And after 3 days, they were thirsty. And they started to scream, we want to drink, we want water. And they said to Moshe, this is our end, we're going to die here. In this desert, so why didn't leave us in Egypt, at least there? Even that they were slaves there, but at least we had some water to drink, and we had some food to eat. All right, okay, we were slaves, but still, we had something to eat, to drink. But in the desert, we're gonna die. So Moshe Rabbeinu, he said to Hashem, we're in the desert, Midbar Shur. Hashem, tell me, what can we do? I would like to tell you something. And I would like, really, it's incredible. This book that I have in my hand, incredible. I didn't supposed to bring it with me. And I think Hashem, he knew that I needed something here. So, after, as I told you before, after 3 days, that they were in the desert, after it was a hard desert, I saw some books that that desert was very, 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 very bad desert. After the Yam Suf, after they crossed the sea. So Hashem, he sent him a tree. And Hashem, he said to Moshe, Moshe, tell the Jews to drink. And from that tree, the water started to come. And Hashem, he said to Moshe to tell the Jews, well, if you listen to Torah and mitzvot, I will protect you. And all the bad things that you saw in Egypt, they will not come to you. Ki ani Hashem of Echa. I am Hashem, your protector. And Rashi said just listen to Hashem and you will see. Because don't forget that in the Torah there is a lot of mitzvot that we do not understand. There is mitzvot that we understand, there is mitzvot that we do not understand. But the most important is that you must have emunah on Hashem. Each mitzvot that Hashem gives you, you have to do them. Now, my friend, I would like to ask you one question. Why Hashem, he give to the Jews that kind of test? I mean, I don't understand. The Jews, they were on a high level when they left Egypt. When they left Egypt, excuse me, listen to this. When they left Egypt, they left Egypt with no food, with no water, with nothing. They had a big emunah on Hashem. Even the prophet, Hashem said to the prophet, I'm so proud of the Jews that they followed me to the desert. I mean, I don't understand. If they followed Hashem to the desert, that means they have big emunah on Hashem. They took no food, no water, millions of children. They just followed Hashem. They believed in Hashem. So now that there is no water, so why they don't pray? Why they have to complain to Moshe? Moshe, hey, we have no water. And Moshe was shocked. He didn't know what to do. I mean, my question is, why Hashem has to wait for the Jews to start to scream for water? So, I mean, if I have a business and people work in my factory, and my factory, there is there a business that you need water. I mean, I have to provide them water. I mean, how can they work if there is no water? So of course, if there is no water, they will come to complain. Hey, you want us to do the business? You want us to fabric that kind of fabric? We need water. With no water, we cannot fabric. So this is a question. Why Hashem, he had to wait for the Jews to complain? They want water, they want food, they want this. I mean, Hashem, he must provide them everything before they start complaining. So this is the question. They said that, okay, the Jews, they believe a lot on Hashem. They did a big sacrifice to leave Egypt. It's a big sacrifice to leave Egypt with children to the desert. They showed to Hashem how much they trust in Him and they believe in Him. But Hashem, He has to understand them. They need water, they need food, they need this. So the only way they have left is to complain. So the question is, why Hashem, He gives them this motive to complain? He should not let them complain. He should give them water before they start complaining. I mean, after all, they followed Hashem. And if you see the Torah said that was a test. Hashem wanted to test the Jews. Hashem wanted to teach the Jews that with no Torah, a man cannot survive any kind of test. With no Torah, a man cannot survive any kind of test. Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, "Vayoreh Hashem Eitz." Hashem showed to Moshe Rabbeinu, "Here's a tree. Have you heard in your life that water comes from the tree? Why not from the sand? I don't know." From stones, from a river, I don't know. Why Hashem show a tree? Why from the tree? The answer is the tree. We compare the tree as the Torah. Ke'etz ha'im hila ma'hazikim ba. You know a tree? Etz ha'im hila ma'hazikim ba. V'tumcheha me'usha. You know, a tree, usually, when every day there is a garden, somebody will take care of that tree, and always you put water there, she will give you beautiful, beautiful fruit. And that tree will never die. It will give you to eat, it will give you to... We compare this to the Torah. The Torah is, if you take care of the Torah, the Torah is like a tree. She will give you food, she will give you life, she will give you everything. Etz ha'im hila ma'hazikim ba. That means that Hashem, He mentioned to Moshe, Moshe, you know, when the Bnei Israel, they started to complain because they need Torah. Now I understand them. I wanted just to teach them that they cannot have a full emunah, a full faith on me without Torah. So that's why Hashem, he wanted to teach the Jews. Because on one hand, we saw the Bnei Israel, when they came from Egypt, they followed Hashem blind. And Hashem was very proud of them. That was good. But it did not carry on like this all the time. Because, you see, the moment that they needed water, they started to complain. I know one thing. People who believe in Hashem did not complain. They accept everything. And of course, without Torah, only with Torah, people who study Torah, any problem that they can have, they will resist it. And I know Mr. Miguel Rosental, Alav Shalom, Menachem Mendel, Ben Hanna, Rosental, I remember that when he started to study Torah, the emunah that he had, there is nothing to compare. Bemet, I remember we were engaged to go to see him in the hospital. This emunah that he had, he knew that that he was in a bad situation. He knew that. But he had a big emunah on Hashem that something is going to happen. Please God. Unfortunately, it did not happen. But he had a belief. He believed in Hashem, even that he knew that the kind of illness that he had is not a... He's a clever man. Today, the doctors that they were taking care of him, they knew that they were doing tests on him, and he accepted. But he had a big emunah on Hashem. I remember the last phone call that he called, when he called me, he said, Rabbi David, thank you for calling me. I will talk to you next week. I'm fine, I'm very fine, and thank you that you came to see me in Buenos Aires. He knew that was the last time I saw him. I saw for the last time. And what he said, thank you for coming to see me, and I feel very fine. How you feel fine? It's finished. No, this is emunah, because it's a man who studied Torah. I remember he used to call me, he said, I had a lecture today, I studied Torah today. And he was happy, he was happy. That was, this is, when you study Torah, the Torah gives you like a satisfaction, the Torah gives you like a relief. You don't suffer. Like people who don't study Torah, when they suffer. But he didn't suffer. He feel very relief. My friend, that was the teaching that Hashem wanted to teach the Bnei Israel. Look, with no Torah, you already nearly lost your faith on me. You started to complain, Moshe, give us food, give us to drink. So Hashem, Hashem to Moshe, you know why they complain? But I only wanted to test them. Of course, the question was, why Hashem had to test them? Why Hashem didn't provide them anything they want before they start complaining? No, Hashem wanted just to test them if they will complain or not. And if they complain, this is because there is a problem, because they have no Torah. So that's why Hashem said, by your head, Hashem, he said to Moshe, throw water on that tree, and that tree will give you water. That means, what the tree, a rabbi is comparing a tree to the Torah. That means, because the Jews needed the Torah, that's why they started to complain. A man with Torah, he doesn't complain. And besides this, there was a problem. Was a problem, because when they left Egypt and they crossed the sea, and the sea started to give them a lot of all the gold that the Egyptians bring with them, they started to take till Moshe Rabbeinu said, basta, stop. Vayasa Moshe Rabbeinu, he started to scream at them, stop, only money, basta, you have to stop. You have to stop. And I think the Jews did something, they did a big mistake. The mistake was, when they crossed the sea, they were in such a high level of all what they saw in the sea, all the miracles that they saw. They were so happy. The women, they started to sing on their own. The men started to sing on their own, and it was a bigness. they were so excited. And instead, you know, it's like when a man is excited of something that is happy, he will never forget. He will never forget that kind of excitement that he had. It's something that it will remain on him all the time. And the Jews, when they saw the gold, it's like they lost all the excitement. Now they were excited not about the American, now they're excited about the gold that they are finding. Money, God. Okay, Hashem, he wanted not to test them. Hashem wanted to give them all the wealth that the Egyptian they bought with them. But really, if the Jews were so clever, they knew that all the matter that they left Egypt to receive the Torah. So, we already have enough. We don't need that. Okay, maybe they will take something and go. But the focus on the gold, the focus on the money that was in the sea. So it's like they forgot a little bit all the miracles that Hashem did with them, especially the miracle that it happened just a few hours ago when all the Egyptians, they drowned in the water. That was another test. Hashem wanted to test them again. Because my question is, did Hashem need it to bring up all the gold that it was a miracle? Usually something heavy, you throw it in the sea, it drowned. But here you see all the heavy things, they come up to the surface. Why Hashem did that? Hashem wanted to test them again. He wanted to test them, would they take all the gold? Or did you say, well, we have enough. We have enough. We don't need it anyway. We're going to be in the desert. Anyway, now we're in the good hand. We're in the hand of Hashem. Hashem will provide us all what we need. We don't need all this. But unfortunately, the Bizat Hayah was very important. The wealth that the Egyptians brought with them to the sea, and when they drowned, it was a miracle that all the gold went up, that blinded them. Is that they started to take. Till Moshe Rabbeinu alav shalom, he said, stop, basta. And I think that warm of emunah that they have when they came out from the sea and then they find all that God, now instead of remembering all the good miracles that happened to them, now they think maybe about, ay, what a pity. Why Moshe didn't let us take all the gold from there? And the question is, why Behemet Moshe Rabbeinu didn't let them to take all the gold that they were there? You know why? Because Moshe Rabbeinu, he wanted to tell them, look, you don't need all this. Now you are under the hand of Hashem. With Hashem you will need nothing. There is no expensive, no spending, nothing. You don't need the money, you don't need the gold, and the desert, there is no business, there is nothing, you don't need it. Like a baby, that he's the head of his mother, he's under the protection of the family, that they need nothing. And I think that because they become a little bit cold, they fake become a little bit cold through all that kind of money that they find in the sea. And on one hand, Hashem wanted to test them again. And because they didn't stop taking money, Moshe Rabbeinu told them, basta, stop. Now we're in a hurry now. We have to rush. We have to go. We have to go to receive the Torah. That's it. With that impact of the money that he did not take from the sea, that blind their eyes. Then when they need it, when there was no water, they started to complain. That Hashem, Hashem was testing them, but there is no complaint against the Jews. Hashem is all right. He's not complaining against them. But Hashem is to Moshe, you see all what's going on now? It's a message for them. When there is no Torah, if they love Torah, so of course they will not wait there in the sea just to take money. Because they know that we never saw somebody who passed away taking with him money. I'm going to remind here. And you see, that's what Hashem is saying to Moshe. Now, tell him, give them the message. When we start Torah, studying Torah, doing Torah mitzvot, they will see the beauty of the Torah, and they will never complain. They will accept. And I remember Mr. Rosental, Alav Shalom, I will never forget that. One day he has a big problem, money problem. That when it was the cash in the banks, in Buenos Aires, and he was with me in Morocco. I remember he wanted to go back to Buenos Aires because a big responsibility, a lot of money, of money people, that he could tell them, well, it's not my fault, but he was an honest man, a good man. All his preoccupation of what to do. And then he said, well, I have no choice. If I have to pay them, I pay them, kapara, but I will go to the kever of Rabbi Chaim Pito and I will pray there. I mean, you see, only somebody who loves Torah. And yes, I remember, he said, how can I miss all the lectures of Torah that we're going to have during this trip in the Ukraine and Poland and Russia and Morocco? He said, oh yeah, I was waiting for that week, for this week. I don't want to miss it. My friend, somebody who has no love of the Torah, for him, money is the best. But for somebody like Mendel Rosenthal, that he had a big test now, but he loved Torah, and he know what it is, the strength of the Torah. But for him it was, well, kapara the money, I don't want to miss the Torah. That's what Hashem said. Hashem, he tested the Jews. Look, don't forget. Because with all the miracles you saw, and because there is no Torah, look, you failed. You failed when with the money in the sea, that you wanted just to waste time, take money, knowing that time is Torah, it's not time is money, time is Torah. You are out from Egypt just to receive the Torah, and now you forgot the main thing, now you just want to take the money. And the second thing, as you know, with no Torah, the first complaint they have to complain against Hashem, you will do it, like now. After all they saw, all the good things that they saw, instead of praying to Hashem for water, they started to complain, well, water, water. My friend, I was there just to tell you a beautiful story that happened with me this week. You know, I am in Israel now. And when I left Paris on Thursday night, at 1:30 in the night, before I left Paris, I had a shower, and I changed all my clothes. And I said to my wife, well, I am now ready for Shabbat. I will arrive Friday morning to Eretz Israel, to Israel, and I am already for Shabbat. The day is short, because it's the winter, and I am ready for Shabbat. So she told me, why from now you change your clothes, your everything? He said, I told her, because who knows? Maybe, I don't know, but I want to prepare myself for Shabbat now. Okay. It was a joke, but my mind was that usually, always where I will be for Shabbat Naranana, there is already there somebody who take care of my clothes there to change for Shabbat, for good Shabbat. For my mind, especially now is the winter, it's raining. So always when I go to Ranana for Shabbat, I have two clothes, two suits, always. Because the last time I was there, it was raining, so it was wet. So always they take precautions. So for me, there is always somebody who take care of my clothes. When I arrived to Ranana, well, I have my small suitcase, just one shirt in case. Always I take more precautions. And I arrived to Ranana. It was 1 hour and a half before Shabbat. So I see in the room of the hotel, there is no suit, nothing. No brush, nothing. No dentifrice, you know, no shampoo, nothing. Usually always in that same room, there is a suit, and there is a shirt, there is always a clothes, and a brush, and a toothbrush for the tooth, for the hair, everything, and there, deodorant, everything. Now there is nothing. And we call the person who live in Ashdod, who take care of all this. Hey, what about my clothes, my suit? Ah, Rabbi, we forgot. Ah, Rabbi David, I'm sorry. Now, what can I do? The time I arrived, Shabbat, I said, no, don't worry, Baruch Hashem, Baruch Hashem. My suit is new. I have, Baruch Hashem, my suitcase in El Al, they give me a brush, and they give me dentifrice, you know, the you know, for the thief, and I have Baruch Hashem, I have everything. You see, my friend, when you love Hashem, Hashem prepare things for you. Look, Hashem, he knew that the man who take care of my clothes, to take them to Ranana, he's gonna forget them. What Hashem did, he put in my mind to put a shirt, a pajama, Bemet, I promise you, it's incredible. I mean, I didn't need to take this all this from Paris, because an Israeli man, he take care of all this. So why? But Hashem, he put in my mind, David, take it. Change the suit. Wear a new suit. Shirt, tallit katan, everything. Use socks. Ella, take. But took a new suitcase. Take, put their pajama. Put their a shirt. Put their. Why? I don't know. Put it. Because Hashem, when you love Hashem, when you want to do Shabbat, Hashem provide you everything. So, and Baruch Hashem, I had no tzar. I didn't suffer. I didn't suffer. I was happy. Baruch Hashem. So I told that man, hey, Amos, don't worry. Everything is okay. Baruch Hashem, because we already prepare everything for me. But then, my friend, but all this is when you love Torah. When you study Torah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu help you. When you study Torah, you take care of Hashem, you respect Torah mitzvot. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he prepare everything good. All that Hashem created in this world, he created it for you to use it. But only if you respect him, if you believe on him, you believe in Hashem. So this man, sometimes people ask me, you believe in Hashem, you believe in history. I don't know what to answer them. Of course, they have a problem. The problem is, if this is the Torah, the Torah is the secret of Emunah. The Torah is the secret of everything. The Torah gives, because the Torah is Torah Hashem, the Torah from Hashem. When you read the Torah from Hashem, that's it. Hashem, he lives on you. It's like a man and a woman. After the marriage, they have a baby. This baby, it's their baby. It's their baby. When you study Torah, you become the baby of the Torah. You become the baby of Hashem. Because Hashem, he gives you the Torah. So when you study Torah, automatically, you become the son of Hashem. Automatically, you become the son of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. How? There is no answer. They just break your head. This is the, there is no answer. I tell you, for me, Baruch Hashem, I need something. I know. I have the address where to go. I have the address, Hashem. Because Rosental Ava Shalom, the years that he discovered Hashem, the Torah, that was his only address. I remember, I would like to finish with this. There was a problem with somebody. And I told him, the only way to resolve this problem is you have to do, bidin. We have to go to ask a rabbi, din Torah, there is a judge. You know what he said? I prefer to lose money, and I don't want to take a Jew to din Torah. No, I don't want problems. Allez, Gera, I don't want. That was Miguel Rosenthal. He was really a tzaddik. Today is his Hezriah. Today is like today, Hartziat. Like today, he passed away on Tu Bishvat. I pray to Hashem that Hashem will keep him under his protection with all the tzaddikim, and I pray for all his family. And I pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu that this week, Matan Torah, and one thing I know, he had a man, a person who had an emunah. This man, he had a big emunah, and a big emunah, and he really loved the Torah. He supported the Torah and he loved the Torah. Yeah. That's the main reason why Hashem, he made a lot of miracles to the Jews only because he wanted to teach them that Hashem, he is their God. And that's why Hashem, he put them, give them a lot of, he tested them a lot of times. To teach them that a real love between a person and Hashem only through Torah. And when there is no Torah, there is complaint. And that, look, after all the miracles that the Jews saw, even that, they always complain, they loved money more than Hashem, all this one because they did not receive the Torah yet. But once they receive the Torah, Hashem told them, once you receive the Torah, you will see that you will not complain against me. Even in the best time that you could have, you will not complain. And I know that once you will discover me through the Torah, you will love me more than money, than everything, more than everything. I wish all of you Baruch HaVetzlacha and God bless you.
Zartu, al arbi haim bintu.